I was a pastor for 30 years, and I've been black all my life. So yeah, it was inappropriate in both ways.
Representative George Young criticizing a floor debate by Representative Greg Babinich over a bill expanding the Stand Your Ground law to include places of worship.
So let's talk about need. Ladies and gentlemen, Madam Speaker, did Rosa Parks have a need to ride in the front of the bus? In a free country, you do not have to prove a need to exercise your God-given right.
To use the name of Rosa Parks, someone who stood for a faith, a belief that things could be better, not by force, but by being nonviolent, just went the wrong way with me.
In response, the representative sent this statement defending his comment, saying he meant to pay homage to the civil rights icon. We're told, quote, it was Rosa Parks' right to sit in the front of that bus, and she should not have had to answer to anyone who might have asked why it was necessary for her to exercise that right. But long before they began debating this bill, lawmakers were already at odds. Supporters like Representative John Bennett, who sits outside of camera view, said it would protect places like churches and mosques.
Because of this evil world that we live in, we have to run bills just like this. It's unfortunate, but it's a good bill, it's for a good reason, and it's clearly justified in Scripture and in our constitutions.
But opponents had both questions and concerns over the language of this bill, like what counts as a place of worship.
I'm concerned that from a legal perspective, we might be opening ourselves up to interpretation.
And who would be responsible for an accidental shooting.
So I would ask that you vote no, because otherwise, God forbid, you ever have a loved one injured in an incident like that, you'll never get justice.
In rebuttal?
When I hear people say, we don't need this, I disagree wholeheartedly. This bill is about protecting my family and my church family in a place of worship.